It's an exciting time for work and a time where we can work with agents. This episode, we'll be working with not just one agent, but two. Stay tuned. So I've got a career, you've got a career, that career kept changing, me too. And that might make you a little bit worried, but I don't worry so much because I've been hanging out with the global career expert, Abhijit Bhaduri, who is here in the Coase AI kitchens. Can you believe that? Abhijit, welcome.
Hey, John, good to see you, and thank you for having me here. So good. I have a suggestion, though.
Please.
Can we turn this I into a B so I have my personalized apron?
Abhi, right? Okay. We'll definitely arrange that because we are the AI kitchen where anything is possible. And as you know, we are super high tech. We have the finest models available. Whoa. But when we began the kitchen, we started out with a grain product, semantic code as grains. And, me, culturally speaking, I come from more of a rice culture.
Same here.
Okay. So I thought we would work with a new product we have of... You know what that is, right?
Yeah.
It's like...
Wow. Dice and rice.
Dice and rice, exactly. Because it's
together.
Like rolling the dice.
Yes.
So I'd like you to add some magical rice dice into the cooker.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead.
Is this good?
That's just... You've done this before.
Once before.
I see. Very nice. Very good. Maybe a little bit more?
Okay.
Maybe a little more. Is there, yeah.
Too much?
That's perfect.
Okay, all right. This is it.
Expert. Okay, thank you. Okay, we are ready to go. Because we have our tokens available, we have a rice cooker running for us. Sorry, toaster today. And we have our models, and we'll have two models available to us, GPT 3.5 Turbo or 4, only the best for you, so we'll have four available for you.
Okay.
All right. What we're going to do is we're going to do multi-agent tech, because all the young people love multi-agents, and so we'll talk a bit about that because it ties into your thesis of workplace. Can you share that with the audience here?
Yeah. So really what we are saying is, you are going to actually have to rethink your career in terms of working with many other people. So that's your, collaboration piece, which is going to become really important. So working with a diverse set of people. And also, of course, looking at the fact that you need to have a portfolio of skills, which is Career 3.0. So doing more than one thing, learning what you've never been formally taught before, that's going to become really important. Mm. Being able to tell your story well. So storytelling skills, personal branding, managing all of that, and really thinking like a venture capitalist. So you kind of have some of your skills which you're building, some skills which are developed, and some where you are an expert like John.
On some days, right? Some days not.
Today is that day.
But today is that day we're at the Coase AI kitchen. All right. Yeah. So, and again, I just want to note, it's so cool to have Abhijit here. He really is a front runner in how careers are being reshaped. And when I began reading your work, I felt more comfortable with being a multi-skilled person. And so, but as you were saying, collaboration, we're in the age of collaborating with AI.
Yep. And AI with each other.
Exactly. That's what we're going to do. So let's open up the recipe page here. And so this is the thing that I made the meal. I've tested it. I used the tester, of course. It's all at the right temperature. So what we're going to do is we're going to bring down a semantic kernel. That's our cooker. We have either the toaster or the oven, the rice cooker option. And then we're going to do is we're going to bring over a model. That's bringing over 3.5 turbo, but for you, let me make it a 4.
Love me, man.
Okay. Abhijit deserves the finest. Okay. All right. We're using 4. And now what we're going to do is this is a utility function I made to make the code look more beautiful when it's printing out. And now we're going to hire a copywriter agent.
Like David Ogilvy.
Well, actually, this one isn't like David. It's not as good. And so we're going to start off with a basic one.
Okay.
The copywriter with 10 years of experience, known for brevity and dry humor. So a general good agent to hire. Not bad. Not David Ogilvy class, but we'll get there next.
Yes.
Okay, so we're going to now make that agent. And now we can just talk with it. So let's see here. I have a new invention. It is chopsticks meets matchsticks. This is going to be a big seller. Big seller. Depends on the time of the year. Okay, now what's going to happen is I'm now telling the copywriter agent, and look, the copywriter says, introducing Chop Match, the love child of chopsticks and matchsticks. Now you can pick your, and I'm like, okay, that's a pretty good copywriter, but David Ogilvy, you know, special place for David Ogilvy's work. So let's hire an art director. Who's actually multi-skilled. They can do art direction, but they can also do copy. And this one has opinions about copywriting born of a love for David Ogilvy. Now, I want to note that if you haven't seen Abhijit's drawings, they're amazing. They're all hand-drawn. So you also know this problem, multi-skilled yourself, you live it, right?
You are an expert in that, too.
Well, you know, everyone... You know,
computers and art, well, design.
The young people taught me that they can just... You can keep changing what you're doing.
Yeah.
So keep on doing it. All right. So now I'm going to instantiate the art director agent. And this art director agent is now going to comment on what the last copywriter did for us.
Okay.
So,
will they get along?
Well, we don't know. Working together isn't easy.
Yeah, and that's going to be the model for the future. So that's a big skill we all need to build.
Can you talk about how people work better together in your experience?
Being able to really respect the other person's point of view, especially when it is different from what you expected.
Why is that hard?
Because you always think that the way you think is the right way to do it.
But my way is the best.
I agree.
But that happens so often.
Yeah, and I think we'll all, you know, as we start working on this, that's going to be the career model, that, you know, you're going to continue to learn stuff, so you have to learn from others. Some you'll teach yourself, and that's where collaboration improves, when you let the other person teach you what they know, and you can teach them what you know.
So be more humble, basically.
Absolutely. Okay. Have that growth mindset.
All right. And feeling the humility here. Art director is weighing in, giving a very pleasant comment back to the copywriter. I appreciate the humor and creativity in your copy. See that respect?
Yeah.
That was good.
Perfect.
Your copy is clever, but it might be a bit too clever for its own good. So sort of gently leaning in. I would suggest something more straightforward, like introducing Chop Match. There's opinion there. Let's now have them work together.
Mm-hmm.
So now I'm going to have the two agents work together. It's going to happen in a loop of three iterations.
Okay.
And now what we're going to see the copywriter talking with the art director. The copywriter says this is a Chop Match, the ultimate fusion of practicality and novelty. Because in a world where time is the ultimate luxury, who an appreciable multitasking agent? Art director, this is a significant improvement.
See, look at that. That's one of the ways in which you can actually work with people who are different from you.
And look how David Ogilvy would be proud of this copy now. That copywriter feels pretty good, right?
See?
And the copywriter is saying, thank you for your kind words. In the world of copywriting, brevity is the soul of wit and clarity key to come. See, right there. Art director, bravo. They are right there as a team. And the copywriter thanks them for the feedback. And now what's happened is... basically, they've co-created. So now, what we're going to do is we're going to take that work, and now the director is going to switch into drawing mode. Because like they did the copywriters, they played the copywriter part of their skill, now they're actually in art director mode. And now the art director has made a prompt that we will now send to an image generation model, DALL-E.
Mm-hmm.
And DALL-E is being brought on board. DALL-E has been paged. And now what we're going to do is take that piece of copy and take that wonderful meeting, that amount of work they did together.
Right.
And it's generated an image that looks like, there we go.
Oh, wow.
That's a Chop Match with a little fire.
That is so amazing.
So now the question I have, Abhijit, as we close up, will this change the workplace, the style of work?
Oh, absolutely. I think, you know, AI is going to change the way that we work. And that means that, you know, the kind of skills that made us successful in the pre-AI model will also need to change. and therefore the workplace. So work, worker, and workplace, that is the magic. So all three will change, and AI is going to do that.
So work, AI augmented work, worker augmented.
Which is the skills.
Yeah, nice.
And the workplace is the marketplace which brings the work and the worker together. And careers will lie at the intersection of these three.
Felt that careers at the intersection of all those three.
Yep.
Think a Venn diagram, ikigai in the middle. Thank you, Abhijit, for helping to cook this meal with us all today in the Cozy AI Kitchen.
I just love this. I mean, incredible. Thank you so much for having me in the kitchen.
Do you have any closing words for our studio audience out there?
I just think that Career 3.0 is going to be an exciting place for us to look at how we think about our careers. Even when you are employed by an organization, you can still pick up a lot of skills which are different from what you've learned. So I think that's the magic.
Wow. I was just on the phone with a friend who has a podcast, long-running podcast, and he wasn't sure, should he keep doing this? But I told him about your work, and he had more creative confidence. So
thank you so much, John. Everybody needs a friend like John.
Well, thanks for coming to Cozy AI Kitchen.
Thank you.
Next episode will be even more, I don't know. We'll figure that out together. Stay tuned.
Thank you. Bye-bye.